I bit my lip like an hour ago, so in this video, if I'm kind of like stumbling when I talk, then do apologize in advance. But with that aside, we have SMT on the AMD side and HT on the Intel side. Now, SMT stands for some magic truffle. So that means if you basically put it this way, if you've got a single mouth and you're eating truffle, then what happens is with hyperthreading and also SMT, it splits it off into two smaller mouths and you can now eat more. Theoretically, you can't, there's not like two full-size mouths compared to one big mouth, but it can eat more in grand scheme of productivity. Now on the Intel side, you've got HT, which stands for holy truffle. And now that's a different breed that was sort of in before AMD had their SMT, so that's why it's got the holy truffle. Now, of course, depending on the brand, if you go with AMD or Intel, both truffles are gonna do a pretty good job compared to not eating any truffle at all. Though, with that aside, when it comes to gaming, do these technologies work? When you split a core into two threads versus having that single core with one thread going in and going full ball, what is better for gaming? Let's find out in today's video after we roll that intro. So coming off the back of our 2013 8-core Xeon versus the 10900K and also the 3950X, I decided after I did this video to run a heap of different tests with SMT off on AMD's 3950X and then hyperthreading off on Intel's 10900K and also the 1680V2. And what we saw here is pretty much going to match up with when I made a video on this in the past. The opinion's pretty much going to be exactly the same, or at least the recommendation, if I recall correctly. But let's get through the results first. With Shadow of the Tomb Raider 1080p high settings, we saw that we gained 3 FPS on the 10900K, then with the 3950X, we gained 5 extra FPS, and then on the 1680V2, we actually lost 3 FPS. So it really didn't make a huge difference. Turning it on or off in this game really wasn't going to make a world of a difference here. But moving over to Fortnite now, probably the most interesting of the bunch, where turning off hyperthreading and also SMT made the numbers worse all across the board. It didn't matter if we had the 8-core, the 16-core, or the 10-core, we were getting less performance. So do leave this on if you want to play Fortnite competitively. It's going to give you more FPS. And then when it came to the 1% and 0.1% lows, they were virtually the same. I mean, 1% lows were winning out in some CPU tests, and then the 0.1% lows were losing out in some other CPU tests. But next up, we have the Division 2 here, and this is where turning off hyperthreading and also SMT showed us that on the 10900K side, we gained 3 FPS, and then on the 3950X, we actually got a sizable boost here, going from 167 FPS all the way up to 182. So it started to really scream ahead with SMT off in this title. This is the same memory speeds, same clock speeds as the previous video we did with these numbers. And so what we're seeing on the Xeon side of things, however, we only gained 1 FPS. So negligible for the Intel CPUs, but it did make a difference for the 3950X. And then over to Tom Clancy's Ghost Recon in Vulcan, we saw here an actual drop in FPS on the 10900K, a slight gain on the 3950X, and then a 1 FPS gain on the Xeon. So really didn't make a huge difference here either way that you look at it. It seems like the 10900K is probably the biggest difference here, but that wasn't even worth writing home about. Though moving over to Warzone, here we've got a similar trend as most of the other titles, except with the exception of the Xeon 1680V2, which scored significantly lower FPS with hyperthreading turned off. And that must be the 8-cores now versus the 8-cores 16 threads, where doubling up the threads gives you more theoretical max performance, and this game is taking advantage of that, as opposed to the 10900K, where it's already maxing out the GPU, and then same with the 3950X, it's maxing out essentially its CPU core component tree, whether SMT's off or whether SMT's on. So in Warzone, I would suggest just leaving hyperthreading on or leaving SMT on. And then moving over to the last title here, we've got Grounded, which is gonna be released later this month, and I got early access to it. So we got here testing out hyperthreading on versus off. On the 10900K, this made actually a huge difference, going from 102 average FPS all the way up to 127. On the AMD side, we went from 92 to 98, and then over on the 1680V2, we still gained a slight boost as well. So all across the board here, we were winning with hyperthreading and also SMT off. However, when I was analyzing this game, I also looked at how many threads were actually being utilized in gameplay, and it seems to only be using 8 threads. And even within that itself, it's only heavily using 2 threads. Though of course, some other last minute tests here, CCX latency, that doesn't change whatsoever on the 3950X side of things. Cinebench scores will change quite substantially, both on the Intel and also the AMD CPUs. And this is to the tune, it can be around 30%. So you'll definitely wanna leave your hyperthreading or SMT on if you're doing any sort of productivity work that can utilize all the cores and all the threads your CPU has to offer. Though, power consumption also during gaming really didn't change a whole lot. The 3950X was winning the bunch there when we tested that in Ghost Recon. And with all those numbers out of the way, my opinion with turning these settings on versus off remains the same like it did. I believe I did this video 2 or 3 years ago, but I remember my conclusion was, in general, you just wanna leave hyperthreading and SMT on with your CPUs. But say for instance, we can see that in certain titles, and depending on the CPU, you can gain FPS. Now, if you are playing that game competitively and you're in that top 1% or 0.1% of people who play that game, and you need to just extract that little bit extra performance, and that is all you do, then perhaps this setting, turning it off, may be something you want to look into. And of course, we only tested 6 games here, but it does show that it's an easy setting just to quickly check. You just go into the BIOS and you can disable it and re-enable it pretty much in 2 seconds, and then you can test the FPS for yourself in that particular title and see whether you need to leave it off or on. But of course, in general, I will restate this again, in general, you just wanna leave your hyperthreading and SMT on, because in general, when it comes to working and productivity, it's gonna give you much better performance. And then of course, when it comes to gaming, depending on the game, it can give you a lot better performance as opposed to the other side of the fence, which you're only gonna be losing maybe 10, and even at worst with Grounded, 20%, and that's an unreleased title. So imagine that game will get some fine tuning in the next few weeks, and once it's got its final release, those differences will be minimized. Anyhow, hopefully this video was some good truffle for you and you enjoyed it. And if you did, then be sure to hit that like button for us. And also let us know in the comment section below, have you tried disabling hyperthreading or SMT in the past for regular use? If so, what was your experience like? Love reading your thoughts and opinions as always. Just like this question of the day here, which comes from Sally Bowie, and they ask, is Ryzen 1500X and B350M Gaming Pro for $150 Aussie a good deal? And it's a pretty decent deal. I mean, you can't go wrong with that. It's not the best deal I've seen out there, but it's definitely a decent deal. So if it was if that deal was around my area for that price, I'd pick it up. So hopefully that answers that question, and I'll catch you guys in another tech video very soon. If you enjoyed this video and you stayed this far and you want to see the content, the moment it keeps rolling out here at Tech Yes City, then be sure to hit that sub button, ring that bell, and I'll catch you in the next tech video very soon.
Autobots, peace out for now. Bye.